we're going to do another, at least another hour, I think, of CK2, and then we'll probably switch over to, wow, look at all this crap going on over here, and then we'll switch over to the multiplayer games. We'll play some League of Legends, we'll play some TF2, and you guys will get to kill me a whole bunch because I'm suck at those games. That's right, I'm suck at those games. But for now, we are very slowly trying to get a little bit of stuff over there. Oh yeah, we need entertainment. We're going to go all out on another feast, another party over here. So we still have the short reign penalty, I'm sure, with our vassals. We do. It's mostly gone, though. Getting there. Going to be fine. We still have the dangerous faction, of course. Nice that we're not at war. And they have some pretty powerful friends. We're going to spend more money here on the feast. We may need it for... we may need some pretty significant mercs if this faction fires. I'm confused. There used to be a thing to ask them to leave a faction. I don't know. I don't suppose there's any chance I can buff up my retinue anymore. Indeed, I can. It's cheap, it's small, doesn't use up very many people. Belial! Thank you very much for the resub, and I hope I didn't miss anyone while I was gone on the break. Certainly possible. But Belial. Prestige, someone approves, we're gonna join the party, prestige. Prestige is good, because you do get, like right now we've got 500 prestige, right? So it gives us a buff to everyone in all of our vassals. Actually, everyone in the entire world, based on our prestige. We get 1 point of relationship boost for every 100 points of prestige. Okay, everyone likes me a little bit more, that's good. And they're still in the faction. Right now, our goal might simply be to sit and accrue a bunch of money so that we can get a bunch of mercs and fight off elective succession, because I do not want elective succession. It would be awful. Simply miserable. I don't think you can ask them to leave a faction if you have auto-ask on. Oh, do I have... I don't have it here. I have it here, right? The auto-stop plots. And maybe that's somewhat related. I have prisoners. I have a baron who's a vassal. I'm going to release you. And therefore, all my vassals... Since he's only a baron, it's not very much, but all my vassals will like me by 5 more. Because I've gone ahead and shown mercy. I'll go ahead and release these 2 people that aren't relevant either. I don't want them in my prison. Should I run a summer fair? It's some money. You get some more prestige and things. While you're holding it, and then there can be some events. I think I'll let it be. So once again, we've got a claim that we can drop on Lorraine over here. I really do want to grow in that direction, but I'm deathly afraid of this faction firing. You can raise 3.4k. I can raise 6 right now. Does that include my retinue? That's just levies. Oh no, it does include the retinues. What do we think, guys? I need a poll. So there's 2 options. There's the play it safe. Name? Question mark. Okay, so option 1. Play safe. No claim. Save money for defensive perks. That's option 1. 2 is lay claim, or use claim, but don't declare yet. Use claim and declare now. So those are the 3 options we've really got. Let's go ahead and make a poll and see what people think. Again, whatever option Twitch may come up with may not be the best one, but it might be the funnest, or, you know, whatever. We'll see how it goes. Quill should name a female child in the game Essentia. Oh, man. I don't want to do that. You know what kind of bad shit can happen to people in this game? Like, it's like if, you know, I was a writer for Game of Thrones and decided to, like, name a character after myself. No! Never. So right now, so overwhelmingly, people want the claim to be used, and the majority is suggesting that we don't use it quite yet. And I think that's fine. I don't believe that our claim will be inherited. by our kid if we happen to die very soon. But other than that, we'll keep it around. We will lose a bunch of prestige, but there we go. So we'll do that, and then Spymaster can make someone leave a faction. Oh, if you put them in the province, that's right. So we will now have a claim on Lorraine. Now, this is just a county. Will not be inherited unless pressed into war. We have to make sure. So we don't have to rush for the Duchy of Savoy. We've got options there. But then what I can do, this duke here, your current holdings, you've got the county of Bar as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this fellow over to there. Fabricate claims. And then we'll wait. We'll let the money recharge a little bit. And we'll be okay. Some people want me to stream earlier. Well, it's hard to make a stream that works for everyone in every time zone. And if I stream earlier, I'm still going to be half asleep personally. Oh, good. We sucked up to our religious fellow. So I'm going to change my court chaplain to research cultural tech instead. I'm still using my spy defensively for now, which may or may not be required. The vassal discouraged from joining factions. Doesn't necessarily make them leave it, but maybe it does. I might want to go and send him out to spy at this point. I have at least an heir. If I get murdered, at least I've got someone to continue the chain. So, yeah, I'm going to send him to spy in Constantinople and hope we get some tech. Oop. Vassal inheritance warning. Thong Owl might leave the realm? Why might you leave the realm? County of Bern. Well, whatever. We'll figure something out. Princess Tenbuin of Burgundy is now of legal age. Look at that. Midas touched. Great stats. My god. Massive stewardship. 21 stewardship on her own. We could marry her off or do something else. She is my sister. So I think what we do is the same thing. A matrilinear marriage. Try to get a relationship, an alliance somewhere. That is worth something. That we might inherit. Like, say, marrying the Prince of Denmark. Or Sweden. In this state of the game, which one would be better? I'm thinking Denmark would be best in this particular situation. You are sickly. Oh, that's no good. You might die before anything comes up. Well, I mean, you might get better as well. Well, maybe Sweden then. So yeah, I like the idea of cultivating some the matrilinear alliances that might lead to inheriting something random. You have an actual claim right now in Scotland. We have a few different ways of getting claims in Scotland, don't we? Oh, you're a bastard, though. We got another Prince of Scotland. It's a couple of different ways to get the Habsburgs in Scotland. So you are a Prince of Scotland, you have a claim on Scotland. You're not necessarily going to inherit Scotland. Scotland! Denmark! I think I'm going to go with this guy. The other guys are kids. We can marry right away. Now, an alliance with Scotland is not necessarily going to be of tremendous assistance. But it's cool. I want Scotland. That's what it comes down to. I want Scotland. Alright. Good luck, Princess Tenbuen. He was proud. Yay! Okay. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we'll let the money add up again. We don't have to press just yet. We've got, you know, we'll live a long time. Sure we will, probably. Speed things up. Hopefully we can get at least another couple of kids. Ideally, I suppose, since we still have Gavelkind Law, having exactly one son might be optimal. But we'll do what we can. In order to bring Burgundy into the HRE, you have to rule over the whole of Burgundy and wait a century. Adela is pregnant again. Okay, yeah, and that will change the de jure borders of the HRE. Yeah, well, we'll work on it. Or we might be able to create another kingdom if I go north or something. We'll see what we can do. Why did Tenbuin arrive at my court? Holy war for someone Okay. Did I not marry you? What happened? Why are you back? I married you to a goddamn prince. Did he die or something? Wouldn't it show, like, previous husbands? I don't see him in the list. Now, we can go and get a betrothal going on here with Somerled, another prince of Scotland. It'll be a 1-year betrothal. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Matrilinear. Now, that might get turned down once it comes of age, because a lot of times the matrilinear betrothals don't necessarily last. Geek Geek sent me $3 for a good cup of coffee. Well, we'll have to go to Starbucks or something later on. Yeah, you accepted that. And Juna sent me $2.50 for some more chocolate. Yeah, the 90% cocoa stuff is really, oh god, it's so delicious. So we're now in a war, which limits some of my activities, but not that much. Mostly just waiting for the money to kick back in. Our retinue is basically capped, so we're not going to have to spend any more money there. But now that there's a bit of a skirmish here, I wonder if it would help to jump now or not. Oh! Duke isn't a child! So he's not going to have as many friends or allies. Oh, shit! This is definitely the time. Look at this guy. Oh, kiddo! You are boned. You are so boned. Interesting. We got two people here who would have a claim on Upper Lorraine, but I don't think there's any way for me to get that and keep it anymore. What's the difference? Oh, this would be my actual claim. This is the one I want to press. Okay, so we're claiming Lorraine for ourselves. Send the declaration of war. And raise up all of our troops. Apparently, he controls a little bit of stuff in Bourgogne. Which is interesting. Anyway, we'll have everyone meet up here, and then we'll split off and go and smash his proper army. He's going to assemble. He's actually getting a few more troops than I expected. For whatever reason. Go ahead and call in some allies. Get the full load over here. He appears to have called in a few. And you're about to go to Lorraine. You'll get there first. Okay. Now we'll keep assembling our main army in place over here. And then we'll assault him. He's not going to have his full morale. Okay. As is, I think we're fine. Can I just select these guys? Thank you very much. Cancel. Go and attack. And then we'll tell everyone else after you've gone to Bourgogne, go up there just to give it an extra, I don't know, tick of something something. Hey, my father-in-law. I don't know if any of these are going to be relevant. Okay, I'm going to do that to speed things along. They're not going to have much in the way of morale. My wife has joined in. Thank you very much. I've been in many situations where I've seen my my wife not join in my war efforts. It's always a little bit annoying. Like, come on! I mean, we're not expecting you to lead troops, not while you're pregnant. But you could at least sort of point in a direction and say, go kill those guys. So I'm really happy for her support. So we do have a slight penalty because of the river crossing. But we have superior numbers, we are currently winning, and we're still being reinforced pretty heavily. So we're going to be fine. And winning this first big battle is the most important thing. And then you just go around and chase them as much as you can. All right. Good, yep. Absolutely smashed. Lovely. And that's without my allies even having shown up yet. Alright, I'm going to group these guys all up together and chase them to... They're going to Saint-Trois over here. Yep! We have new heir! New heir, it is a son. He is... I have a genius! I have a twins. Again. Is my family, like, more likely to pop out twins? Okay. I have a son who is a genius, who is my heir. Yeah. And his name... His name is going to be... M. Wit is going to be my genius son, heir to the Kingdom of Burgundy. And his twin sister, we're popping out twins like crazy, is Rockin' Rimmer. Rockin' Rimmer. We fulfilled our ambition, which is great. Now, can I fulfill an ambition to not have any more sons just to try to keep things, you know, clean? We could try to become a chancellor or, well, we can't become the religious fellow. We'll try to see if we can become a chancellor. Skill 11 is not great, but, who knows? We'll go ahead and do that. Maybe it will happen. Ha 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 ha. We don't even have, like, we're not a genius and our wife is not a genius. The hedonist. Massive fertility. That'll be interesting if we pop out too many kids, but there it is. I don't think I can change my focus yet. Oh, I can, actually. So, I'm gonna go ahead and... Straight up war, straight up hunting, actual intrigue, rulership, I don't think is necessarily required. Scholarship, I think we might go to all up war. At least until we get some of these good events. Hunting is pretty good too, though. Especially with that health bonus. We'll go for the health bonus later. We'll start with war, see if we can get an event that gives us a trait, and then we'll switch to hunting or something. Just transfer Duke of Savoy to the Emperor, then declare war for his duchy. Oh, I see. You're right, I could do it that way. That would get him out of my hair. We'll see what we can do. We've done that. He's going to run back to Lorraine, where we'll go ahead and squash him, and then finish off all the sieging entirely. We got... Oh! A daughter born to Prince Adam of Scotland and Princess Tenbuin, named Elenir. Alright, good. And that's under my family name as well. Very useful. Mm-hmm. Alright. Now that we can raise up a decent number of troops, maybe I didn't need to get in the allies for this one. But, because I could do a pretty decent war for some of the bits down here. I really want this guy to be obey me. Instead of the stupid other king. But yeah, if I transfer the vassalage, because I still have a claim on the Duchy of Savoy. So if I transferred Savoy to the Kaiser, I could then declare war on Savoy. That is... Yep. So I couldn't just make him unbe my vassal directly. Like, and make him independent, but I could do that. Okay. Thank you very much for that, that tip there. That's going to be really handy. I think should be a relatively short and very successful war. Not need to use any mercs or anything of the sort. Very good. We still have plenty of domain limit. Which is great. Favorite subject does not interest me anymore. I'm losing the zealous trait. Ow. Oh well. Zealous is really nice, though. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, people are talking about airplanes in the chat. I keep being very close to picking up one of the flight sim airplanes for, like, the Airbuses, like the A321 or something like that. There's some great ones out there, but I think it's still a little bit beyond me. Betrothed can marry. Is there more than one Tenbuin going on? There needs to be just like a reset for everything here. Nope. But didn't Tenbun have a daughter somewhere? Oh my god. Okay, so she did get married, she got pregnant, her husband died. No, her husband didn't die. Her husband joined the church. Wait, what? They have a daughter. She's not a bastard or anything.
So, they got married. They had a... My sister got pregnant.
And then he left her to become a bishop? Can that happen? And then she's marrying his brother. Her marriage ended because the dude became a chaplain. Alright. Anyway, we'll get another match in your marriage going on there. Terrish 20 just subscribed. 13 months in a row. I think that those are like the longest people, because I've seen another 13 months, and I bet you that's just how long I've been on Twitch as a partner. Didn't they already get married? Yeah, no. Okay. Yeah, that'll be a story for the kids. So, your half-brother. Okay, so this is M. Bauer, who is a kingsman. So, just someone of my dynasty. So, really, anyone can educate him, although the advantage of assigning someone to educate is it'll make them happier or like me more. Well, here it doesn't really matter. Yeah, you know what? Tenbun is like a great steward, if I recall correctly. So we need more people in the family who are like that. Good organizers. God ripped up a beautiful marriage. Aww. Christian Ninja, subbed for a year. Stop recurring subscriptions. Get noticed again and now this. I'm so sorry. You won't get the achievement. I know you've been around forever, too. Mm-hmm. A few more little wars breaking out, none of which are relevant to me in any way whatsoever. Yay, the Siege of Nancy. Is mine here, yeah? Yeah, because I can't piece out there, okay. 83%. So happy this guy died, made it that much more viable. But yeah, we should go after Savoy. I got a great book. Hang on a sec. They're still talking about planes. Hey, we're pregnant again. Still talking about planes in the chat. There's this guy, Captain Gib Vogel, who's written a few books about flying various Airbuses. I don't have any of those. I have the flying... Hang on, let me check my camera here so I know if I'm pointing right. I have one he wrote called Flying the Boeing 787. And he doesn't actually fly the 787. It's a great little book. It talks about how the plane was built, some of the systems, and it does a sample flight. The sample flight is, I think, from Japan to LA. Yeah, Tokyo to Los Angeles. And it's really fantastic, and I love it. I'm probably going to have to pick up some of his ones that he wrote about the Airbuses. I think he's got two or three of them. Can't remember, but it's very cool. All right, preggers again. If it's a son, we'll have, you know, obviously things might split up a little bit. The Duke is fabricating a claim. Now, the fact that he's fabricating a claim means I can try to imprison him without the tyranny penalty this time around. We're going to finish this war first. And then we're still going to have our entire army raised. We're going to move the entire goddamn thing over to Savoy and imprison him. Because screw that guy. Enhance culture. Fair bit of money. You know what? I'm going to say no right now because we don't have unlimited pots of money. There we go, 100%. Offer peace, enforce demands. Okay, good. What is this? Special action. The following special actions are available. Dual theory. Who, what? My rival or something? A duel to uphold my honor. Can be considered dangerous to my health. I do have the war thing. Yeah, so I think I can duel things at this point. Let me get back to you on that. Now, okay, do I actually want to imprison him, or do I want to do the vassal transfer trick? Which might be the better idea. I can tell him to end his plot. I have evidence that he's leader of the plot, so I can do it easier. Or I can do it without being tyrannical. But I'm not necessarily going to win anything from doing that. Duel him. Badass. I'm sure it's based on a relative martial stats. My martial's actually not very good. Yeah, we're about even with my rival over here. People want me to duel. Okay, what could possibly go wrong? Luckily, I already have a genius son. So, if I die... The chat is requesting it, so let's go ahead and duel my rival. Slow it down. Keep walking everyone near Savoy. Let's fight! Chosen to accept your challenge to personal combat will take place in the coming days. Day of your duel against Thierry de Boulogne has arrived. A small crowd has gathered to watch your fight of honor and glory. Thierry starts aggressive and throws attacks at you, which you manage to dodge and block. Over time, you gain the advantage while your opponent is getting more and more fatigued. Finally, you feint a high attack, and Thierry fails to block your strike, which hits him in the leg. Your opponent puts down his weapon and yield. I can walk away as the victor, which would give me 50 prestige and make him wounded, or show him no mercy, which would still give me 50 prestige, would kill Thierry, but for the rest of my life, I would get the merciless trait, which would make everyone like me by 10 less. I feel like I should do a vote at this point, but I feel like they would go no mercy, and that would be really bad for me. So I'm just gonna, you know, mercy is the mark of a great man. Well, I'm a good man. Well, I'm okay, but I'm still gonna walk away. Oh, everyone wants to kill. I gotta walk away. I don't want to take the minus 10. Hey! Okay, I did get the strong trait now. Which is wonderful. Would have been maybe nicer if I'd gotten it before. Although I can't complain, I got a genius son. Alright. Very, very good traits. So, with Savoy. Alright, I think we're gonna go ahead and give it a try. We'll try to transfer him away from us and then declare war on him. Because he can't actually raise up many troops. So... I transfer vassalage of the Duke. Oh, he's not on the list. I can't. I can't give the Duchy of Savoy to my king. Only counties. Why is that? That trick's not going to work. So let's just go and arrest this fucker. I will go ahead and move my marshal. Oh, he's still in Savoy. Okay, so he's still there. I'll get all my troops in place, and I'll just try to arrest him, because screw this guy. Doesn't strong make you even more fertile? Yeah, I think it does, actually. We're going to be popping up babies like crazy. Hooray, Gavelkind. But that's okay. It makes the game more interesting. We'll arrest this fucker, and then we'll go and declare war for the south. Alright. Here. You. You are under arrest. 61% chance of arresting him. Boom. We've got him arrested. So, now that we've got him there, if we had... Oh, we've got some people we could really... I can ransom you. I don't need you. Or you. Oh, you're the same person. But here we've got Amade. So, I could... Again, I can try to... I can't revoke the title. Because we don't have the authority. And that would be the normal thing. You arrest them... Actually, because he didn't fight back, I don't know if I'd be able to revoke his title the way I'd want. I could have him executed. But I'm not sure that actually helps the cause. I heard a beep, 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 beep. Rasko! Turns out my brother is watching the stream at home and at the same time I'm watching it at college. I saw my saw my comments Twitch chat. That's pretty funny. Oh, and Nerolosa! Oh, Essentia's getting a Starbucks fix, apparently. We're actually, assuming everything goes according to plan, after the stream, we're planning on going to, a Mongolian grill tonight, which I've never done before. But I get the sense that you get to, like, sort of pick and choose what's on your plate, and then they go, is he possessed? Ah, that's funny. You get to pick and choose what's on your plate, and then they cook it. Which will be good, because I'm still, you know, mostly following a diet plan right now. Feeling good about it. It's all going to get destroyed when I go to California. By the way, I'm trying a, is it Five Guys burger? Or In-N-Out? What's the burger in California that I need to try? You guys will remind me. But I'm going to have to try that. So my diet's going to go straight out the window. He's possessed. Wow. That's really funny. So, yeah, I don't think there's much we can do. I mean, I could banish him. Yeah, minus 60 for everyone. We don't want to do that. I'm not going to ransom him. While he's in prison, he has a lot less ability to do stuff. We look, his diplomacy is minus 10 while in prison. He'll probably at some point ask me to like release him under house arrest or something like that. I can just throw him in the oubliette at that point, and he'll heal over and die pretty soon. So I don't know if that affects the factions. Yeah, there's no factions at all. Now, it may have already been gone, or it's possible you can't run a faction from prison. I'm not sure. So, what I want to do now is lower my personal levies. And I think we're going to war. Oh, he's a kid as well! Oh, he can only raise 3,000 troops and he has no allies! This timing is perfect! Every time I want to go to war with one of these fuckers. So, we could claim Provence for a couple of people. Oh, hold on! We do want to do this because I'm the de jure liege of the Duchy of Provence. So if I go and claim Provence on behalf of Rosa or Elizabeth, either way, because it falls under my kingdom, they will be under my heel. Which is exactly what I'm looking for. Let's verify here. The Duchy of Provence, de jure, belongs to the Kingdom of Burgundy. Yes. Okay. Guys, this is going to be fantastic. So, again, declare war. Who might I want to declare war for, actually? Elizabeth. I can't really see what she feels about me. 35. Is married to someone who's already one of my vassals. Okay. Alternative 2. Is Rosa. Oh, the wife of the Duke. No, fuck no. Wow, good thing I double-checked that shit. So we're going to declare war on behalf of Elizabeth. To claim Provence for her, which will then, and she will bow down to me. She will kneel to me. I think I got that right. Let's check the chat here. Nice to see RNG's turning around for now. Yeah. Philippine's liege de jure, but fights crime at night. And I know it's supposed to be like de jure, but I can't help it. What could possibly go wrong? Yeah. Alright. Send. We are at war, ladies and gentlemen. And we will go and raise up all of our troupes. And if I'm going to say du jour wrong, I may as well say everything wrong. And we'll move in. Actually, maybe we'll do something like that. Yeah, I won't attack yet. Now, there's a lot of mountains around here. Okay, yes, we're ransoming off some people. I will go ahead and try to call in some allies, just because this might be probably not. I won't call in everyone, though. Just a couple here and there. We're probably okay. Oh, you can't join. I don't have any more ransoms I can do. Katarina, I will ransom you off. And then we have a bunch of people. I basically just took a bunch of, like, kids and wives and things as I was sieging, so we'll release the rest from prison if there's no option to ransom. As long as I don't release that guy accidentally. And all these people who are being released, they will actually like me a fair bit. Now, I'm not getting a boost with my other vassals, but I will get a boost with them. And you never know. They might come in handy. Refuse to pay. Oh, because I think I released her. I think the ransom was just 2 gold. Oh! Okay, he did call in some more allies. So I will go ahead and call in my final ally over there. They're not pouncing on me instantly, so we're going to be okay. My wife is joining me. Thank you. Thank you, wife. Let's move into the forest. This is forest, yeah? As opposed to attacking the mountains, which are going to have kind of samey numbers. We're going to try to avoid that. I probably should have jumped on Vienna right away. My sister-in-law joined in. Lovely. I like how two of my allies are actually, like, ladies. Who is the other person? Who is this? Countess Agnes, who's married to my brother, but she's the one with the actual title. And, oh, her heir. It's in red because it's the wrong dynasty, because the heir is going to be a Habsburg. So a Habsburg is going to be in control of this county, which is wonderful. And Woody just resubscribed for the fourth month in a row. Hello, hello, Woody. I actually really like this because I hated when I would say something like, oh, welcome to the party. Nice to see new faces. And people would be like, no, dude, I've been here for like 100,000 years. Get your shit together, yo. When are you planning on arriving there? The first one will arrive on the 18th of... Oh, February. It'll take you forever to get there, which is fine. And we have to be a little concerned about the rest of these guys. Tell you what, I'm going to actually change their path. End up in Geneva, which is hilly. And then maybe Lyon, and then here. Get everyone to group up. Because, yeah, I don't want to be the attacker on even footing in the mountains. That would be bad. We don't have an overwhelming extra set of forces. There's a lot of troops over here, though. This is my Austrian army. A lot of people involved in this war. Yeah, it may be smart to have gone and cleaned up some of these first, as opposed to besieging over here. I'm not sure. If the Brasgauian troops show up over here, we will get pretty overwhelming odds to potentially attack in the mountains, but I don't know. Hey, we have a new daughter! They're really trying to force the name Sybil on me. But instead, we're going to have... Oh, this has actually been the name of one of my CK2 characters before. We're going to have Princess Haflablab. Haflabab. Welcome to the family, Haflabab. The 2-to-1 numbers into the mountains is basically what we're going to be looking at. I don't know. That's dicey. Austria is eventually going to come to us, though, and then that might put us over the edge and make it a winning move. Meanwhile, we can sit here and at least start sieging out their stuff, which will impact their ability to reinforce or do anything of the sort. Yeah, 2-to-1, plus this will make us almost 3-to-1 odds. Yeah, fighting in the mountains sucks. But it may be well worthwhile, assuming that they actually join in the battle. Could probably just sit and finish the siege first, regardless. Hopefully, if the Austrian troops join me in Vienna, which I suppose would make... Well, no, that's not Vienna. This is Vienne, which is in... What is this place? Alban, Vienne? Because, I mean... Vienna... proper is somewhere over here, isn't it? Yeah. Wien, as some people like to say. There we go. That's not Vienna. That's Vienne. That's somewhere in France. Where are you running to? You're going to go to Provence, which is... Provence is mountainous? Are you fucking kidding me? Is there nothing but mountains everywhere? If Austrian's up here in Nice and then gets attacked... I'm gonna break that siege. We're gonna chase down. No. Let them engage you. Yeah, okay. Survive. Where's my force march button? I needs it. Bum 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 bum. Alright. I don't think we're gonna get there in time to be on the offense, which really, really, really sucks. They haven't taken much damage. We're still at better 2-to-1 odds. The mountains are really harsh. But we're still at better than 2-to-1 odds. It took a few hits and they weren't at 100% morale. It might work. Looks like their left flank is going to break instantly. Okay, this is going to be good. Yeah, they're breaking. They only got a skill 2 leading there and a skill 0 over here. Okay, we're able to crush them. I probably could have started that sooner, but better safe than sorry. Losing that first battle is crippling. Looks like this big-ass army is going to come down. Nope, just sieging a little bit, which is okay. We'll go ahead and follow you into Provence and just try to finish you off completely. It'd be really great if we can capture someone important. Alright, and this is their actual capital. So what I'm going to do is... oh wait, there's a split in half button, right? We discovered? Split in half. Grab half. Send you into Nice, which is in the mountains. Good. Severe winter mountains. Possibly go wrong. And then we'll siege a couple of places and just let that go down. Especially the capital. It'll be very valuable to have some troops sitting there. If these guys decide to make the march down here, they may decide to attack me in one of these places. Everyone's attached here, though. How do I just select the army directly? I don't know if there's a way to do that. I don't think they'll attack, because I would have actually liked a slightly smaller group here to bait them into attacking me in the mountains. And then I could just shatter them. They might come around and attack me in Provence, which would be okay, because apparently Provence is the mountains. Sacrifice your Austrian brethren. Yeah, just a little. It's just a tiny sacrifice. Hey, we get some tech points. Do-do-do. We are going to have to start building buildings soon. We're starting to make some money finally. But right now we can still apply the money to a lot of warfare. So I'm not rushing out to necessarily improve my family castle. Ah, but this is a fine way to spend some money. But I get a claim on the county of Bar. And we'll go ahead and move you to Saint-Trois anyway. And all told, we'll have claims on like every part of the Duchy of Upper Lorraine or whatever. Prince... Summerled of Scotland and Tenweb. Okay, so this is Tenweb's second kid. No. Yes. Yeah, there we go. But it's this guy's first kid. Trude? What a... Trude? No, you are going to be named... Stelfox 101. Stelfox 101. Welcome to the Habsburg clan, my friend. Meanwhile... Pakistani Atheist is doing a little bit for the whiskey fund. Very important. Very important fund, of course. Oh man, we're pregnant again. Alright. Now, so far, we only have the one son, which is make our succession very, very simple. We'll keep a lot of duchies under direct control, which is nice. But, you know, we'll see how it is. We're popping up babies like crazy, though. The strong trait is definitely part of the game. I mean, we could do something. She's also got the plus 10% fertility from the Fortune Builder. But it's okay. We're Habsburgs. We want to get Habsburgians everywhere. So, it's okay. So many bebes. I think Way of Life does make CK2 a little bit more interesting. Has it been long enough that I can change my focus yet? No, not yet. Since we have gained the strong trait from the war thing, we could switch over to maybe get the hunter trait at some point. So they're not really sieging much. They're wandering around. They're trying to attack me, but I think every time they show up, they're like, oh, mountain's bad. Whoa! Hold on, though. All right, we just want a siege. And they are actually going to attack me. And I'm more than happy to let them. So the 9th. So on the 8th. Sometimes they like weirdly show up one day early. Oh, it actually did. Look at that. It dropped. One of them will arrive on the 8th now. So on the 7th. There we go. I think it has to do with skill. On the 7th, we will start this move. We will break this siege quite willingly to be able to beat the crap. No! What? How? Alright, whatever. Why did they cancel? They were one day away. Maybe the engine works differently in CK2 than in EU4. But in EU4, you can start moving the day before and they can't change their mind. Now, next time, you know what? I won't worry about saving a day. I'll let them commit fully to the combat. Honestly, in the mountains like that, there's like a million different ways we find... Oh, we just finished that siege outright. So let's go ahead and move up over here. That actually might bait them into attacking me in Provence, which would be okay. This is still mountainous. Yes, indeed. We're only at 34% war score, but I'm feeling all right. Feeling groovy. It's going to be a big one. Can I create a CK2 tutorial? Well, I could try. I've done some of it. Some of my earlier Let's Plays were semi-tutorially. CK2 is weird because I find that it's both one of the more approachable ones, but also a little bit confusing because there's so much stuff that goes on. I can probably raise another set of levies. We have decent leaders on this army. So what do I have to do? I have to pause, start a move, and then cancel. Okay. And yeah, I can't rearrange the armies very much just because of the low authority. We might be able to finish the siege and then join in the battle if the timing works out well. Oh, because they're going to jump in on the 13th. And I have to reinforce right away, even at the cost of this siege. And we've got the mountains. We may have been okay, but probably not. And certainly not enough. I'm not willing to risk it. We're going to jump in there and make sure to bop this army 100%. Yeah, no, we were going to lose, so it's good that we got in there. But that should turn it around relatively nicely. I like the flag of the King of Burgundy. Cool. I think anything on the blue background looks really good.
I have the high ground, Anakin.
So it's not going to be like a total rout. Oh, their middle collapse. That's kind of odd. Not used to seeing that. Usually it's the flanks that drop off first. Currently in the pursue phase, this is where we actually slaughter a few more people. We've got the count. Another count. That's really good for the war score, actually. I'm going to group these two armies together. And then... okay, the 26 is moving this way. Oh, they just stood there. Okay, no, now I think they're going to escape down here. We don't have a ton of morale, but I think we should still be in a good position. We got another girl! Okay. We're not going to be splitting up the kingdom, but we are sure as hell going to be spreading the von Habsburg name as far as we can. So, this one is going to be Rivare. Or Rivar. River. River Song. Welcome to the clan. Child lacks a guardian. Princess Hojoke, my daughter, currently needs a guardian. So, let's get you edumacated by this bishop, which will improve relations, which I like very much. So we will go ahead and do that. Now, you are my eldest daughter, though, right? And currently only have one son? Actually, I'm going to educate you directly. Because right now, you are second in line. If something happens to M-wit-wit-wit, then you are the... you're the spare at this time, so I will educate you myself. Boom. There we go. Plus, I like getting the events for the kids. Is this smart? Okay, this count here. Rusko! Oh, yeah, I remember seeing you talking earlier. Thank you very much for subscribing. Appreciate that. Hang on. So this 3,500 includes everyone, including Austria, like all my allies and everything. So we're going to be going in here, not at 2-1 odds, attacking into the mountains, and we actually don't have that much morale at this time. I think I'm going to sit here for now, actually. And we may be able to increase our levies a little bit again. Get an extra couple of troops here and there. Not very many. We're at 79% war score. Oh, they might go and try to recap Nice, which would be a little annoying. Looks like that is what's going to happen. Pope Sebastian or Sabian? Sabinian has died. Sabinian. Yeah, I don't know. I tell you what, let's move down to Provence. I'm going to siege something. We'll siege the actual capital. Plus, it makes me adjacent to these guys. And we'll see what happens. M-wit-wit-wit. Such a beautiful name. Boy so nice, they named him thrice. Won a minor skirmish there. Up to 80% war goal, war score. They start desieging stuff, it'll be annoying. Having the capital is nice, of course, but... also, the fact that we hold so many people makes a difference in the war score as well. Apparently not. 44% of the war score comes from a single battle. Wow. Alright, my daughter could permanently gain one diplomacy and get kind? I don't think I've ever seen one of these just flat out give you +1 points. Oh, we'll do that. We're going to turn into our super kid. Okay, we're at roughly 2-1 odds here. And he's still at... oh, no, he's at full morale. Misreading this. 2-1 odds. 2-1 odds. What kind of leaders we've got? That's decent skill. We actually don't know what kind of leader skills they've got going on here. 2-1 odds in the mountains in severe winter. No. I don't feel comfortable doing that. It'll suck to lose that. Oh. It's nice to do this, though. Split you in half. No. Split you in half, but only take part of you. Go and bop these guys. Because we'll never lose the war score from the battles. Which is nice. And the last thing we would want to do is lose a big battle. Lose all our momentum and a bunch of war score from doing that. This is not worth terribly much. But you get a little bit of war score here and there. And I think it goes a long way towards sort of breaking their will. That should change his mind. Then we can go here and sandwich him. Ooh, yes. Attack me somewhere, buddy. Oh, you're running away. Interesting. No, you're going to come down to Provence. I will 100% let you engage me in Provence. And then I will destroy you. Let's do this. You're attacking me in the mountains. We're going to give Joffrey a chance, but then we'll replace him later. Attacking me into the mountains. I got massive reinforcements. There's the end of the war. Patience! Patience is our reward. Whoa, we actually stack wiped him completely. 100% war score. Enforced demands. The Countess gains a county and a duchy. And she should bend knee to me. Assuming I did this right. A duchess. Yes! Yes, 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 yes. Lovely. And she loves me because I pressed her claim plus 200%. So I have a super duper loyal duke or duchess under my spell. I'm going to go with spell. Any cool plots I can do? I can kill my rival. Whatever, I've already beaten him up once, it's fine. And we have, okay. Hartman over here loves me for some reason. Oh, he's one of my friends, but he was forced to fight me. Oh, that is so sad. He was forced to fight me because of his liege, but we're actually friends. So I will clearly just release him. Plus, this should give me a... Oh, I thought it would give me a plus 10 trait with everyone. It didn't. Alright, I'll just ransom him. No offense, buddy, but, you know, all's fair in love and war. This duke? Nope. Won't give me a relationship boost. I don't know why. Or this count. And I do not want to release Amadee. Because he is a big jerk face, and I hate him. We got another claim. And we got claims all over the place there. I will go and move. I'm going to keep moving north, I think. Fabricate a claim over there. I don't suppose I'm in position to declare any wars. We have a truce? You're possessed as well? What the hell? Press all claims. Lovely. You're different. You're not... Right, because I was fighting a war against the kids, so whoever owned this place changed it around. You are possessed, drunkard, master seducer. Alright, we're gonna move up over here. Sometimes it's time for a break. Ah, and I said I was gonna start doing some multiplayer stuff. We may have to wait until the next time before we press this particular claim. Small spear throwing contest could be fun as well as helping you train for battle. Should you arrange such a contest at your court? Sure, what could possibly go wrong? Probably related to the war thing. Oh, the Knights of St. John have been formed. Okay, so we're going to get some holy orders, potentially, for next crusade. Okay, I'm going to move here. Everyone in the spear-throwing contest is having a great time, throwing spears, discussing, and laughing, basically enjoying themselves, maybe enjoying themselves a bit too much, as a spear is thrown carelessly while someone is out of the field, measuring the distance from the previous spear, so a bishop has become maimed. Oops. Well, we'll press our next claim, since we can do the whole press everything button, which is really nice. We just got a bunch of prestige from that, which is lovely. Oh, we missed the opportunity to have a feast, but I think that's all right. I no longer feel a fear. I'm now brave? Holy crap. Listen, I'm going to start running, like, all my battles at this point. I still don't have that much marshal. If I died at this point, it wouldn't be so bad. My ward... Hey, we've become friends! Me and my daughter. Oh, that's nice. I like to see that. Oh, I don't suppose I can get more retinues. Can. I mean, I could wait until, like, a really good set, but there we go. Heavy infantry is always very nice. Go and join up there. Obviously, we're paying to, you know, restock these guys. That's all right. So, time to go to war before something interrupts us. We'll win this war, and we'll call it quits. Press all claims. I love the fact that that button exists. Send. Raise up everyone. Oh, and I've got my big army down here too. This is the new duchy. Nice. Let's group up here to start off with and see where we want to go. Yeah, because I figured walking directly into here would be kind of dangerous. Don't necessarily want to siege Burgong first, just because it's not a high priority target. Because it's just one of the baronies in here. And once we're together, we'll go and smash their main force. Whoops. How come I can't merge? Oh, because I don't have it selected properly. We dat. Shotutsu just subscribed. And Silodon says, execute Order 66. That's the one where you kill all the Jedis, right? Can't remember. Pretty sure that's that. The Jedis, these guys ain't. We do get a river crossing penalty, but we've outnumbered them so substantially that it's not going to be any kind of concern. They don't even have flanks, so we should, I think, be getting bonus. Yeah, plus 30% damage bonus. And they use different tactics, which do different things. Now in the pursuit phase. Oh, my commanding presence on the battlefield was felt during the recent victory by friends and foes alike. You bolstered the spirits of the men when it was needed most. You personally led the final charge that broke the back of the enemy army. Song will be sung of this day. Songs will be sung of this day. Reckon right. They're gonna be like power ballads. A little bit of arena rock. Could call in allies, but why bother?
Finish them. Wipe them out. All of them.
Alright. And then swing back over here. These poor guys getting moved back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And then we'll just siege them out. Ooh, okay. I don't want to focus on the flank because I'm usually going to want to lead from the center. Mastering defensive terrain. Plus 50% narrow flank. I don't know what that means. Bonus to rough terrain. Forests and hills. We do have a lot of forests and hills. It's too bad it doesn't cover mountains. Fights best when positioned in the flank. Yeah, so he's got a penalty from the center. And I'm mostly going to want to be in the center, thematically speaking. Perfect from terrain for defensive battles. Well, we do get defense-y a lot. I'm going to take the rough terrain. I think it's just going to be easier for me to sort of use, if I remember to use it ever. If things are going swell right now, I suspect Quill's character is about to die. I'm sure you're right, Bidensis. Almost assuredly, something terrible is about to happen. But I have a great heir. Now, there we go. New Marshal, that's fine. I have a fantastic heir. If I died right now before having a boy son, another boy son, as I apparently like to say, then that's okay because our kingdom will be nicely united. Is there not another province here I can take? I guess I can go and sit over here. Siege out all the things. Oh, there is another province there. Okay, I was pretty sure. There we go. Keep everyone together. And these are my, Provencal troops. Provincial troops. Really? You can't siege out there. I'm actually quite surprised. So let's send you a smattering of extra dudes. I'm sure that must be enough. It's be something like 2,500 you need. Oh, you're just short by like a dozen or two. There you go. Get an extra 500 men for the sake of argument. 38% war score. Really, honestly, it should be bigger than that. Although there is a Swabian army running around here. Really? You're allied to the, Count Gotzello of Innsbruck. Marshal of Bavaria. Designated regent. Interesting. Should I designate my wife as my regent? You can do that, right? If I get maimed, you take charge until our son comes of age? Apparently I can't do that. He's going to come here. They might decide to attack me in the middle. In which case, I'll just sandwich them and crush them. That's okay. They'll hopefully at least get a river crossing penalty. It's a force as well, so we get a bit of defense. They'll be on the 13th, which is now. I'm gonna make sure not to move the actual army that's in the middle. Every now and again, you get some wonky ass shit that happens there. So you're gonna get flattened. That'll be a lot of war score, and it also breaks your morale pretty considerably. 94%. Oh, and we actually wiped it completely. Nice. Would you peace out? Not yet. Fair enough. And fair enough is my subtle way of saying, F you, dude. But I'm Canadian, so sometimes I gotta be a little passive-aggressive. Ah, we lost a Stuart. Ah, Somerled, the Prince of Scotland. Yes, I will go ahead and assign you to do that. That's fine. At this point, no, we don't have the money for it. I think continuing to collect taxes is actually the way to go. So go ahead and do that. So as soon as we're done this war, we're gonna move on to League of Legends. Make sure your client is patched and set up for North America. We're gonna do some free-for-all, ARAMs, just goofy stuff. Everyone can try to kill Quill, which is very easy to do because I'm terrible. Doesn't help the fact that, man, like, I used to play a lot of League of Legends, but I have not put very much time. The only time I've played any League of Legends in, like, the last 2 years is for these livestream ARAMs. So I don't know what most of the characters do anymore, but I used to play a lot in the beta. A lot. That was too long ago. Okay, let's speed up to speed 5. I think... Whoa! Okay, they're not actually attacking me. What war is this? Oh, the King of Aquitaine. And if this battle gets lost, they might come and decide to just bump me. Oh, no, I've got troops here. How come my troops aren't participating? That's weird. And yeah, they did lose. That means they will instantly then go and blow up my troops? Just in case. Well, there's no way I get out of here on time. They take these guys and leave. Okay, they are... Oh, I'm ill. But they're not actually fighting me, so we can keep sieging here. Unless they're... Oh, maybe they were in Verdun? Yeah, okay, I think that's what was going on. The graphics are weird here. But yes, they're in this province. They're not in the province I'm at. And now they're being chased down by a proper HRU army. Okay. Ooh. Peace yet? Nope. I mean, at 97%, they do it eventually. But it'll get sped up. I'm about to win one siege and we're going to be okay. Yeah, some of these provinces are a little snaky and it's hard to get the positioning exactly right. Wait. Again! Woman, can you not hold on to a husband? Again! He left to join the church. Okay. So, her first husband, who got her pregnant and then joined the church, has died. So her second husband, with whom she mothered another child with, has then been promoted to the Bishop of Dunkeld. This bishopric of Dunkeld keeps stealing my sister's husbands. What the hell? She's cursed. All right, let's marry someone else. No, you're not going to marry my son. That's not going to work. Tell you what, we're gonna go ahead and try Denmark this time around. He's only 8, she's 21. It's going to take a few years before it comes to fruition. There we go. Matrilineally marry the Prince of Denmark. My poor sister! I mean, in her defense, I'm sure people are just being appointed to those positions. Like, I'm sorry I have to leave you because I have to join the church now. It's just the thing that happens. My bad. Fuck Texas. Yeah, Jero says, this is why I love this game, and Bronco Billy says, that sounds like a storyline from a daytime soap opera. You're goddamn right it is. It's crazy. That's what CK2 does. It's all about these emergent little stories. It's not about the warfare, it's about the crazy bullshit marriages and weird things that start to happen. Moo moo! Victory! Okay, we're now at 100%. Thank you. Offer peace. Enforce demands. Bam! We've usurped the title of the County of Saint-Trois, of Bar, the Burgundian War. That's, I think, just to change the vassalage. Lovely. We are now at 7 of 8 of our domain limit, which is perfectly manageable. We can go ahead and drop these down. I'm surprised I actually can't create a title or something. Here, du jour, this is a duchy of Upper Lorraine. This request would be denied. Ah. So usurping titles that way, or claiming titles that way, is kind of tougher. But don't I control everything? Don't I control Lorraine, Saint-Trois, Bar? Yes. But someone is still the duke of these places. This guy. Maybe something will change soon. Did I lower my troops? I did. Okay, and then take my retinue and just move them home. Just want to see if there's going to be another weird pop-up or anything. Really time for my king to keel over and die and let my genius son take over. On the other hand, long reign equals much more stability. He's only 26. He can get a lot of crap done. I shouldn't be excited about necessarily getting my my son on the throne. Just the idea of keeping everything unified is quite handy. I can change my focus. I could go to hunting at this point to increase my health and live for a very, very, very long time. Get more stewardship. The hunting events are pretty cool because then you get the hunter trait, which is pretty beefy. There's also a lot of things to say, like I could grab Krausing for just a big diplomacy boost because diplomacy is very, very important. Also, invite to Kraus sounds like fun. I've never done that before. I think what we'll do is we'll put a cut in here. It's a good place to do it. We have continued to gain some power here with King Ripplesaurus Rex of Burgundy, who is, I think, the fourth ruler that we've run. He is the grandson of the person we started with. His brother was ruler for a little while and then keeled over dead. Actually, all of my siblings, other than Tembwin, who can't keep a man, no matter how hard she tries, all of my siblings are dead. I'm actually quite surprised about that. Huh. Well, alright, folks. Independence? No, I think we'd get our ass kicked. But it's something to consider for the future. We're going to wrap up the CK2 portion. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, we're going to start playing some League of Legends. Everyone is invited to join us in the League of Legends. And then after that, we'll play a little Team Fortress 2 with subscribers. So we'll see what we can do. But for now, a short break. And I can feel I'm starting to lose my voice. So it's a good time to stop with the CK2. See you, catch you on the flip side.